Guys, I'm just doing a little quick overnighter with a chap that a few of you might know, subscriber 1A, or John as he's actually known. He's my cameraman for tonight, so how are you doing, John?
Lovely, yeah. Smash him.
What I'm going to do is just quickly show you how I prepare one of my favourite camp dishes, which is actually some salmon fillets with jacket potato cooked in a fire. And how I do this is I actually use tin foil. Once you're done with the tin foil, you can take it home with you in the morning. Now, I'll get my salmon fillets. And what I'll do is I'll lay them out onto the tinfoil and I'll get some butter and I'm going to sort of rub the butter into them a little bit. It's a messy job, but what that's going to do is it's just going to make the salmon nice and moist. So you want the butter to be all around there. Got another piece over here. Anything that's sort of unhealthy for you really is going to be tasty. That's the way that I look at it. And it is pretty messy, but again, anything messy, it's going to be tasty for you. So that's going to be nice, that is. And then once I've done that, so there's a bit of butter all around my salmon, what I'm going to do is I'm going to get my lemons, and I'm just going to sort of squeeze the juices out onto the salmon as well. Salmon and lemon, bloody lovely. And once I've done that, I'm just going to lay it on top, just because it's going to carry on giving the salmon a little bit of flavour sort of whilst it's cooking in the tin foil there. So we'll lay them on top. Go, absolutely lovely. That's it. Jobs are good in. And then what you need to do is you need to wrap this up. So you want to wrap it up quite well. Get a couple of layers of tin foil around your salmon. Really, it'll create a good seal. So effectively, what that's going to do is it's going to steam in its own juices and the butter as well, just to make it extra juicy. And that's it done. That's going to go in the fire now for sort of roughly 20 minutes. I'm going to just put embers on it rather than have flames over it, because I don't want it to cook too quickly. But first, what I'm going to do is I'm going to start my two jacket potatoes off, because they're going to take a much longer time, really. So we're probably looking at about 50 minutes to an hour for the jacket potatoes. So they're going to go in first, give them about 40 minutes, and then these will go in for the last 20. So what I'll do is I'll take you over there and show you what I'm doing. So I'll see you in a sec. Alright guys, so what I've done, I'm just trying to show you here, is I've just moved a load of embers out of my fire, and the jacket potatoes in the tin foil are just starting off now. So in about sort of 55 minutes or so, the fish is going to go in. We'll scrape some more embers out, put the fish on them, and then give it about 20 minutes. Job will be a good one then. And then tea will be served, eh? Sounds good. Right, folks, so I've just put the fish on there. You can just see it this side here. So there's loads of embers sort of surrounding it just to keep it nice and warm. So yeah, give it about another 20 minutes. We're just sort of keeping the fire going on this side here. It's going to be a little bit hotter just to make sure the spuds are cooked all the way through. And then we'll pull it all out and open it up. And hopefully it will all be cooked, although I'm sure it will do, because it's a... not my first time doing this. I'm sort of getting quite used to timings, that kind of thing. Right, folks, so just pulled everything out of the fire now. Just let it cool for a couple of seconds just to see if you can actually get your fingers on it. Let's see if we're all wrapped this. Yeah, that's mighty hot still. Smelt good. Let's have a look. Oh, look at that. Check that out there. Beautifully moist. Beautifully moist. And especially when you're putting the butter in there as well, it just helps it to never dry out really. As long as you seal it well. Look at that. Have a bite of that, eh? Well, that's perfect. Got the lemonness there as well with the butter. And that great salmon flavour. It's lovely and tender. We've got the spuds here as well, and you can tell when they're done. If you can give them a squeeze a bit and they're nice and soft, you know that they're going to be all right. They're going to be pretty much done there. Right, let's get the other one open, eh? And have some tea. Job's a good one, so I hope you like that, guys. There we are, so the fish is already gone, but you saw how beautifully it was cooked. And this is the spud halfway to being done there. I say done as in eaten. Beautifully cooked, isn't it, mate?
Absolutely perfect, yeah.
So yours isn't too far behind there.
No, no.
A couple of bits in there. We've just got the fire back going as well, just to keep us warm while we're eating.
Skin's going last, meat and the skin last.
Oh, yes, you can't beat a bit of potato skin. If you don't eat it, guys, you've got to get it down you, because that's where all the nutrients is, actually, with the potatoes. It's not like sweet potatoes. You want to eat the skins of these kind of potatoes, baked potatoes, because it's where all the nutrients is. Anyway, I'm going to crack on with my tea. So I hope you've enjoyed this little video. So I hope it's helped you along with your camp cooking and that. Thanks for watching, folks. Bye for now.